anyone is trying to make money off of anything other than the US dollar, I think that these banks start to get scared. Here's what I think. I was talking to my wife about this earlier. My wife and I were talking, and I've explained the idea of stablecoins to her. My wife is not, you know, she loves the fact that we've got a bunch of crypto and understands the value in it, but doesn't truly understand it, right? And yeah. So I was explaining to her the idea of stablecoins, and she really did seem to understand it. And she said, well, why would you be holding money in a regular bank account then? And I was like, bingo.
Exactly.
And there it is. So I said, you asked the question, right? There it is. Someone new that's just trying to figure this out says, well, wait a minute. If that's the case, if you have an asset that's stable that you can actually get returns on versus the 0.01% that your bank's going to give, why would you do it? And so, yeah, I mean, ultimately, that's what's going on here. The facts are our country is run, whether we like to admit this or not, our country is run by the legacy financial system. The banks run our country. When the Lehman Brothers went under in 2008, that was a massive deal. When all these banks were the ones that got bailed out, because at the end of the day, guess what? That's who runs our country, whether we like to admit it or not. So now we have an invader on basically coming in on their quote foreign soil, on their territory, right?
Oh, we have an asset on their turf, right? It's a turf war right now.
Absolutely. We have an asset that says, hey, look, by the way, I'm going to stay worth $1, right? And oh yeah, we've got places that can give you 4, 5, 6, 8, 12, 20% for that asset. Where do you, once people start to really understand what's in front of them and truly begin to actually trust these smart contracts and trust these yields that we can get off these stable coins. If the banks don't do something now, if our government doesn't do something now, these banks are in trouble, because the moment that this becomes the norm and the banks aren't doing anything to get on board, they're screwed. And what I think is going to happen here, Miguel, I think the regulations are going to get thrown out, that if you are pushing out stable coins, they've talked about this, you are going to be considered a bank, right?
Yes.
And so they're going to be putting banking regulations on these stable coins. Well, where does that actually lead? I'll tell you where I think it leads. I think it leads to our current legacy financial system saying, hey, we will give you safe haven and safe harbor of your stable coins. We will actually allow you to hold stable coins in our bank. Oh, how freaking nice of you. And then let me tell you what they're going to do. They might even give you 1% or 1%, 2%, 3%, only because they have to, because other competitors are offering more. But I think what they're going to do is they're going to regulate it so that they are giving you that. And then guess what? I truly believe this. I truly believe that they are going to, like they always have, find other avenues to gain more yield on those stable coins, right? That we are currently taking advantage of. I think they are going to jump in, take advantage of those same platforms. And then guess what? Now they are once again the middleman. And at the end of the day, the whole point of these stable coins and decentralized finance as a whole is to get these banks out of the way, and they keep injecting themselves into our lives. And at the end of the day, I think it stinks.
Yeah, I definitely believe that 100% right. I believe that that is exactly what they're going to do. They're going to try to find a way to become relevant and turn the tables and say, well, look at us. We used to give you 0.0 whatever percent, but now we're going to give you 2. We're going to even, sometimes we're going to, you know, on a special day, we're going to run a special. We're going to give you 3% if you sign up and open a bank account with us now. So come on in. You know, we're awesome. We're hip. We're crypto. We're all about it. But, you know, keep your stuff with us, because they're going to then be doing that same thing with their stable coins and putting it on whatever, you know, platform that they either create or so on to get their 8 to 12% easy on stable coins, right? I wouldn't be surprised that they're going to start creating their own bank coins.
Yeah.
We saw some of that in 2018, right? 2019, these bank coins coming out. JP Morgan wanted to create its own bank coin. Mm-hmm. And why? It's for that purpose, right? People were like, wait a minute, why would anybody want a bank coin? Who's going to use that? They are. They're going to use it. They're going to create some type of platform where they themselves, the banks alone, have access to, and they're getting a bunch of yield from that stable coin that you are giving them, right? You're parking their money to, in their banks, and they're giving you maybe 2 to 3, or they're getting maybe 8 to 12 on it. Once again, making your money work for them and making money for themselves off of your backs and giving you crumbs, right? Yeah, because they're offering you. Go ahead.
No. Continue.
They're offering you safety. They're offering you custody, right? If our bank gets hacked, we will protect you. We will make sure your money's here. Don't have to worry about your keys. Don't have to worry about losing your money. If we get hacked, we're backed. We're backed. We're insured. We're gonna give you your money back. And that false sense of security is gonna get people to jump on there for 2 to 3% when they themselves could be getting 8 to 12%. And so another point that you said earlier about once people start getting to trust these smart contracts, it's not about trust. It's about people getting educated. So when they get educated, they understand what it is, because when you don't understand something, you don't trust it, right? But it's not because there's something wrong with it. It's just you yourself don't have the education to understand what's really happening. Once you get educated, you're like, wait a minute, what have I been doing in my life this whole time? What have I been thinking? I've been wasting time not being educated about this. Where have I been? And then they jump in, right? Anybody that reads the Bitcoin Standard doesn't walk away saying, whoa, what a load of crap that was.
Right. Yeah.
Wow. You know, what a waste of time that was. Man, I wish I would have never read that book. If you're saying that, it's because you're now seeing the nightmares and you're like, oh man, I've just been red pilled, right? I've just been awakened from the matrix. And now I see the reality that I've been living in this whole time. And these machines have been controlling my world and this putting me in this simulation, making me believe that the US dollar is where I should be. I should be parking my money in a bank account and save, lower my spending so I can save more. Yet they're devaluing your dollar constantly. And your saving is actually being stolen from you through an invisible tax that nobody foresees. And you're never gonna get rich working hard. You're never going to get rich saving money. And it's not even about being rich. It's about being financially free. You're never going to get freedom that way. Never. You're never going to get freedom by following the one running the system. That's just not the way it's going to work.